Hey all, hope you all are coding great. I am Atar Tiwari and in this video we are just gonna code our JS file for our video calling JavaScript application. So in this particular video we will just add our audio, video and stream elements. So that will be useful for our video projecting on our meeting grid. So all these elements are useful for the video projecting on our screen, that means on our video. So let's don't waste our time and let's get started for that. Okay guys, so now we are on our screen. So in the previous some of the videos, we have just coded our HTML file and the JS file. So this coding is of our JS file. So we will firstly add our video element in this whole file. So to add the video element, let me just paste the video element here. Okay, so here I have pasted the video element just below the join meeting area section. So here is the video element. In the video element, you can see that I have used this keyword video. So this particular keyword video denotes this video in the HTML file. This denotes this video. Where's the video tag? Okay, let me find that video tag. Okay, where is that video tag? Yeah, so here is the video tag. So we have used this video tag here, so that will be useful for our webcam video projection. So here is our video tag. We have used this video tag here. Then likewise our video frame, we have also used our video frame in this particular area. So video frame, we have also used a video frame. Likewise now you can go through this code. Secondly, we will add our audio element, as video and audio are both important in a video call. So as we have done with our video element, now I will add the audio element. Okay, so here you can see the audio element. So likewise video, we have also used audio in our HTML file for the audio thing, and autoplay and play inline and control, all these are controls in our buttons that we have provided to the users. So this is our audio element. Secondly, after the audio element, we will set up track. So setting up track is really more important than video and audio element. If we just have created the video and audio element, then it is okay, but it will not project the video to the in the meeting grid. But if you have to project your video, then you have to set up the track. So here is a code to set up the track. So firstly function, then setup track, and then stream. So here you can see it is using video element and audio element as in parameter. So after that, there is all the code which will be useful because of this particular video and audio element only. Then all the code and also the share stream. So you can also our platform Zoo also provide you to share this event. So you can also share this event to different mediums like on Facebook, LinkedIn or various YouTube stream. You can even live stream our event. So it will be useful for this particular share by on this share. So now let's test it out that our code is working or not. So let me open the terminal. Okay, let me just change directory and turn on our Node.js server. So for that, npm run start. Okay, so now our our server is now started, and now after that we will just change our directory to the folder. Yep, and then I will run this on live server. So now our project, yep, so now our project is running on live server. So let me just switch my screen. Okay guys, so now I have switched my screen to my web browser. So here you can see the live streaming of my web camera on this screen. And firstly I will enter my name here. So my name is Atharv. Yeah, you all know that my name is Atharv. And after that I have to enter the meeting ID. So as this is a fresh meeting, we don't have our meeting ID yet. So I will click on create meeting, and here you can see our video is live here. So here this is our meeting grid. So our video is live here. That means our code is running successfully. So that's all in this video. If you like this video, just hit that like button below. Also subscribe to our channel for more updates, and till then just stay tuned to the more of videos. In the next some of the videos we will just work with these buttons to turn on these buttons to give the functionality to these buttons. And till then, stay tuned for upcoming videos. Thank you for watching this video. So stay safe, stay happy, and happy coding to all.